They're saying they're using this video and sending it to teams like they do every week or every couple of weeks as far as a teaching point that this is not the way to do it, which blows my mind. There is a rule, though. Rule 12, Section 2, Article 9 of the NFL rulebook states the technique of grabbing the passer from behind the legs, scooping and pulling in an upward motion is considered a foul. And they're saying that's what he did. Mike McCarthy, Clay Matthews' head coach, says, the goal is player safety. I think that's number one. Number two, it's to protect the quarterback. But also, I think you have to go further. I think anytime you have a desired result, there's a formula to get that result. You got to make sure you're looking at all the variables. I'm not sure all the variables are clear right now. So I understand that rule, and I read that rule, but I completely disagree that this rule applies in this hit.
Correct.
With the way the forward motion of Kirk Cousins throwing the ball, Clay Matthews tackled the quarterback the way the NFL is now teaching, wants youth football to tackle with heads up, to not use your helmet anymore, to wrap and to drive through a player to keep your feet going. He did all of that. And his right hand went around the waist of Kirk Cousins. His left hand went behind the leg because that's where he was in the body part of him. And his momentum of going one way, Kirk Cousins' momentum of throwing the other way, and then Clay tipped him and dropped him and put his hand out. I couldn't disagree more. And here's my thought. And listen, I'm not going to stop watching football. I'm not turning it off. The ratings aren't going to go down and all that. It's all fine, okay? I love the game, and I'll always be part of the game. But I'll say this. For those that are involved in this that looked at this and are now used as a teaching tape, if there's a group of people at the NFL, and I get along with a lot of them, and it's not like a friendship ends with any of them either for this. I just disagree. For those that did not play football at a high level, I get it. You don't know.
Yeah.
In all honesty, you don't know. For those of you who are in or part of the league and are involved in this decision, who played meaningful football and looked at that play and agree that it was a foul, you're the ones I'm looking at right now and saying, you know what? You should, quite honestly, you should be embarrassed. You should be embarrassed. That part of the game, you're fundamentally changing from what is a picture book tackle right now. So that would be my point. If you're at the league and you played meaningful football and you looked at that play and said it was wrong, that's who I have the biggest issue with, because you're the ones that could really supply the input that says, no, I get the safety. I get taking the head out of the game. I get all that stuff. Now we're protecting the quarterback. I get that. But again, to what end? That was a picture book tackle. If you're at the NFL, you played meaningful football, and you agree that was a foul, that's who I have the problem with.
Von Miller never tackles a guy and he ragdolls him. He's just so freakishly athletic. He does actually gently take the quarterback down almost every time. This just in, not everybody can do it the way Von Miller is doing it.
Well, no, I think this is less about a lot of that, because Von Miller only proves that these guys are aware of why these things are happening.
Correct.
And they understand the value to their league. The difference is, and you mentioned what Mike McCarthy said, and I think that hit at the heart of it, is this feels more like a missed opportunity for me. For a league that wants to certainly deter certain things, and deterrent and these rules we talked about have had an effect. You can see the hesitation in certain areas, but in addition to having things act as a deterrent, you also want to reinforce positive behavior. And like you said, so much of this embodies what you want out of new tackling in football, that you had a chance to look and say, no, we got this wrong. This is exactly what we want. We want to reinforce that this is the type of behavior that helps, that creates the NFL that we all want to see. So that's the disappointing part, is you missed a chance to highlight something that's actually a result of all the work you've been doing.
That's a great point. That should be a highlight tape sent all the way down to youth football to say, this is where we are now, gang. No more head in the game, shoulder, drive through a man, wrap up.